When you think of tyranny, you think big, oppressive, authoritarianism, right? Jackboots, secret police, general Orwellianism. Well, you'd be right. But tyranny, like any evil, can be insidious, subtle. Far from a hard tyranny of positive rights and hard restrictions on activity, it doesn't restrict, but nudge, bending the will of the people rather than breaking it. This is known as a soft tyranny. While different than the Orwellian nightmare of a hard tyranny, it is no less oppressive. To quote from the man who coined the term, after having thus taken each individual one by one into its powerful hands, and having molded him as it pleases, the sovereign power extends its arms over the entire society. It covers the surface of society with a network of small, complicated, minute, and uniform rules, which the most original minds and the most vigorous souls cannot break through to go beyond the crowd. It does not break wills, but softens them, bends them, directs them. It rarely forces action, but it constantly opposes your acting. It does not destroy, it prevents birth. It does not tyrannize, it hinders, it represses, it enervates, it extinguishes, it stupefies, and finally, it reduces each nation to being nothing more than a flock of timid and industrious animals, of which the government is the shepherd. Alex de Tocqueville, Democracy in America. So what does this mean? Well, if the government wants you to stop driving, they don't ban cars. They would impose car and or gasoline taxes. They make cars unsafe to drive in the name of some unrelated cause, or put out some campaign to convince you to stop driving your car. If the government doesn't want you to start a business, they won't ban starting new businesses. They'll simply require you to get a license, comply with zoning regulations, tell you what kind of people you have to hire, what benefits you must be forced to pay for, and whether or not you're able to fire them. If the government doesn't want you to be free, they don't write out a list of positive rights, stating what you're allowed to do, everything not listed being illegal. They simply grow the list of things you're not allowed to do, like collect rainwater, own a gun, buy a gun, defend yourself, practice medicine, teach your own children, like pictures online, sell lemonade, leave the country, grow a garden, let your kids play outside, not recycle, pay in cash, criticize Islam, be a war veteran, wrong think, have kids, not own health insurance. The worst part about it all is it gives the state the moral high ground when being confronted about it. Why are you complaining? You see, we're not stopping you. We're making it so that you want to stop. It's just as bad. A soft tyranny is every bit as oppressive as any Soviet Union. The difference is that they think you're too stupid to recognize what's being done to you, reduce you and your humanity to that of simple taxed livestock, domesticated industrious animals good for nothing but working, paying taxes, and killing foreign taxed livestock in pointless wars. Every minute law regulating voluntary activity is an inroad to totalitarianism, and it must be pushed back against, always. But how do we push back? It begins with education. Spread the word. Whenever you see or hear about a petty law that restricts someone's freedom or an abuse of power, share it on social media. Tell your friends. It might not seem effective, but if 10,000 of us were doing that, we could make a difference. If we don't, well, it won't be tomorrow, but you'll wake up one morning wondering what the heck happened to your freedom.